Shown here is a distribution of wind speeds. This could be the actual data, or it could be a Weibull distribution. In this case, it's actually the Mount Tom data. So it's the number of hours the wind blew at different wind speeds in different bins over a month. So in this case, it's not annual data, but monthly data. And let's overlay on top of this a wind turbine power curve. So we typically don't see power curves drawn out like this, but we were using a bar chart to show sort of where they overlap and really to signify that we're going to multiply these two values together. So the amount of power that would be produced at each within the bin of each wind speeds is going to be multiplied by the number of hours that it spends at that wind speed. If you used instead the actual probability, which sums up to one, then this would be the give you the average power rather than an energy output for the site. So let's go ahead and show what happens when you multiply those together. You get the red chart here in the middle. And you might notice that the peak of this chart, or the wind speeds that provide the most power and energy, are in the 8 to 9 meter per second range, whereas the most prevalent wind speeds were back here in about the 5 meter per second range. And of course, this is a combination of the power curve, but also because the power in the wind is a function of the cubic velocity. So there's usually a higher wind speed that gives you the most power output than the one that is the most prevalent.